Welcome to the second section of our lesson. This one's called The Correct Use of Color, and it's again brought to you by PrintWand. Previously, we learned about how to interact with fonts in Photoshop. But now, we're trying to ensure the correct use of color in our files, whether that be using a Pantone, also known as PMS colors, or a four-color process made up of the inks cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. Either way, your goal should be to use one or the other, but you don't want to use both. So here we have our Photoshop file, and we have two seemingly identical pieces of artwork. When we lay one on top of the other, we can see that there doesn't seem to be any difference between the two. Okay, so let's go over to our Layers palette, and we want to double-click on the layer style of one of our layers. And we're going to head down over here to Color Overlay, and we'll just click on this colored square right here. So we can see here that this is a PMS or Pantone color. This means that it's one color when it's printed. It only uses one ink. Okay, so let's close this and then look at the next piece of art. We'll head back over to our Layers palette. We want to double click again on the layer style, the next layer, and we'll head down to Color Overlay and again click on this square. Now notice here that this one is made up of a four color process. It uses four inks, like we mentioned before, cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. So this is just one more thing to keep in mind when we're setting up our documents. It's not that one is right and one is wrong, it's just one more thing to be aware of with our artwork. And as you can see, it can be easy for the colors to be mistaken for each other. Whatever process that we've indicated to our printers, whether that be PMS or four color, that's how our document should be set up, with one or the other. Another habit to get into would be always trying to send original files, in this case Photoshop, to our printers. It just makes things easier for them if they have to make changes at some point in the process. So this finishes up our lesson on the correct use of color in our Photoshop files. Our next section will discuss how to achieve a multicolor look in a one-color document. Make sure to check back often to PrintWand for more video lessons as well as other articles to help you with your marketing and promotional needs.